When it comes down to big cars and big engines, there's truly one domestic car manufacturer that comes to mind, since, you know, they just insist on sticking 700 horsepower of engine into literally everything they can, including now a minivan. And that, of course, is Dodge. The latest of their modern muscle cars have definitely impressed, and the community has taken to them, I would say, pretty damn well, which can only mean one thing. People need new wheels for these cars. So what is going on, everyone? Joe from Fitment Industries, Fitment Industries Garage, and we are back with another episode of What Wheels Fit. And today, since we already covered, you know, the Dodge Challenger, we thought we'd only be fair and go over the Dodge Charger. Real quick, before we go ahead and get into today's video, if you haven't done so already, don't forget to subscribe. It helps us out a ton. And of course, once you watch this and know what wheels are gonna fit your Dodge Charger, don't forget who helped you out. Hop on over to fitmentindustries.com. Check out all the options that we have available for your Chargers, your Challengers, your anything else that you might have. Just have a good time. First things first here, we are going to be looking at a general fitment range here of 20 to 22 inches for the diameter, 8.5 to 11 inches for the width, and an offset landing anywhere between plus 45 and plus 10. It's a pretty wide range. The tough part here is going to be having to deal with that lovely 5x115 bolt pattern, as it's usually not one of the most extremely common patterns out there. So that gives us an idea of where to start, but still gives us a huge range as far as sizes and fitments go that fall within that. So what we're going to do is take a look at some of the Chargers sitting in the gallery right now and go over what people are running as far as wheels, tires, and suspension to give you guys a first-hand look at what certain setups look like on these cars to help you decide what setup you want to go with. We'll start off with some more modest sizes and things like that, ones that would be good for daily driving, and then work our way up to some more aggressive looks and fitments. That being said, let's go ahead and get into our first car of the day, which is going to be this 2016 SRT 392 with some Valgan VMB5s. We are mostly going to be looking at staggered sizes for these cars. This one specifically, we have a 20x9 with a plus 20 offset in the front and a 20x10.5 with a plus 25 offset in the rear. For tires, we have some Nitto Motivos 275/40 and a 315/35, and then sitting on some K-Sport suspension. No spacers, these are true fitments, and this setup has no notes of having any fenders rolled or any other modifications needed to get this setup to work. Overall, a very flush, aggressive looking setup that just works damn near perfect for this car. Up next, we have a black 2016 SXT with some Verde Axis wheels, and these are a 20x9 with a plus 20 offset up front and a 20x10 and that plus 25 in the rear again, so same size wheels as the previous car. For tires, we have some Nitto Motivos again, but this time a little bit smaller for the size, 245/45 and a 275/40, and then sitting lowered with help from some BC Racing coilovers. Some notes here that the fenders are rolled and have a slight pull to help make some extra room for being this low specifically, but seems to have really alleviated any rubbing issues that there might have been without them rolled. Moving along here, we get to this 2019 Scat Pack 392 with some Ferrata F8 FR6 wheels. This time we have a 20x10 with a plus 15 offset up front, and a 20x10.5 with a plus 20 offset in the rear. Switching the tires up a little bit on this one, we go some Nitto NT555 G2s, which are a great tire, by the way, 275/35 and a 305/30, and then sitting on some BC Racing coilovers again. No rubbing, no requirement of having the fenders rolled, and this setup still getting a pretty damn decent flush fitment. Getting our first look at one of these bad boys on some air suspension, we get to this 2017 with some Vertini RF 1.7s. And these are a size of 20x9 with a plus 15 offset up front, and a 20x10.5 plus 20 offset in the rear. Some Maturo AZ850 tires, 275/40 and a 315/35 for the size, and like I said, sitting on some air suspension. Even though it is a tucked fitment and on air, we are still seeing a pretty good size tire, which I think is absolutely awesome. I'm a sucker for a tucked meaty tire setup, especially on new gen muscle cars. Up next, we get to this 2018 392 with some Rohana RFX11s, and these are a 20x10 plus 20 up front and a 20x11 plus 20 in the rear. Some Nitto NT555 G2s, again 275/40 and a 315/35, and then all that sitting on some Airlift Performance air suspension. No rubbing, and fenders are still not rolled, and somehow still able to tuck those 11 wides in the rear. Getting into our final two cars, we're gonna take a look at this 2019 Scat Pack with some Valgan SL10 wheels, 20x10 plus 17 up front and a 20x11 plus 22 in the rear. Paired with some good old Nitto Motivos, 275/40 and 315/35, and then sitting on some H&R lowering springs. Which brings us to our final car of the day, which is one of my favorites sitting in the gallery right now, which is this 2017 Scat Pack rocking some Stance wheels, SF07s, 20x10 plus 20 up front, 20x11 plus 21 in the rear, with some Cooper Xeon RS3 tires, 275/35 and a 305/35, and then of course, sitting on some good old fashioned Airlift with performance air suspension. If I had a new gen charger, that's what it would look like. I'm telling you, that's all I want. So there you go, those are some fantastic examples of some chargers sitting in the gallery right now over at fitmentindustries.com. You can go check them out for yourself along with all the other ones that are sitting over there as well. You can get all the specs, you can get all the suspension, you can get all the details as far as any trimming, fender rolling, anything that you needed. It's all over there, fitmentindustries.com. While you're over there, check out some wheels, tires, suspension. And if you have a charger that isn't in the gallery yet, or if you picked up some wheels, tires, suspension, and you throw them on yours, please add them to the gallery so we can keep making videos just like this. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'm Gels from Fitment Industries. We'll see you later. Peace.